These men are developing a sensitive feel for the power beneath them, practicing coordination between the hands and feet, and operating all controls without looking down. One of the necessary coordination exercises is between the left-hand clutch and the right-hand throttle. The throttle is extremely sensitive. Too much power will throw you off balance. It can cause the rear wheel to spin or the cycle to slip completely out from under you. Not enough throttle, and the cycle will jerk. This clanking of the rear chain is known as lugging. A cycle clutch is built to slip at low speeds without damage. In slow traffic, it is necessary to slip the clutch in order to hold power to a steady RPM. If additional power is desired, decrease pressure on the clutch control. For less power, increase pressure on the clutch control. Next, you must coordinate the braking action. Since the bulk of the weight is to the rear, it must become automatic to always apply the rear wheel brake first. This ensures more positive braking action while still retaining steering control. Not too hard, or the rear wheel will lock and skid. Then gently apply the front handbrake. You should practice this drill until it becomes automatic. Before attempting to start your engine, be sure your cycle is in neutral. On manual start cycles, improper kicks can result in badly bruised legs. Such injury can be avoided by holding the knee in a locked position. Then, with the starter pedal at the top of its arc, throw the full weight of your body straight down and through the pedal until it is disengaged, and hold it there until the engine has either started or ceased sound and motion. Of course, this problem is eliminated on cycles equipped with electric starters. Always anticipate any power surge in order to maintain proper balance and posture. Correct posture will eliminate backache and strain on the kidneys, as well as improve your control over the cycle. Distribute the weight of your body between the seat and the footrest. Lean slightly forward with the knees in against the tank. Keep the foot near the brake pedal. As you practice starts and stops, you no longer have to think about what the hands and feet are doing.
So you see, Doctor, with training of this kind, operating a cycle becomes second nature. You react instinctively, and your mind and vision can concentrate on what's going on around you.
Well, there's a lot to it.
Yes, there really is.
How about a cup of coffee?
Fine. It's a common misconception to believe that if you can ride a bicycle, you can automatically operate a motorcycle.
I hope you take it blank.
Cycle is a wonderful machine. You mentioned earlier two of its greatest advantages, visibility and maneuverability. I'll even add two more, economy, and I get a real kick out of riding it. But with each of these advantages, there are certain hazards that every rider must be prepared to face.
I'm afraid you've lost me, but go ahead, I'm interested.
Well, for example, take a look at me. What do you see? Protection against some of the hazards inherent in cycle riding.